Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. And today I just wanted to come on here and share a quick mini haul from a couple little places. I placed an order from AliExpress, so I have quite a few things that are going to be trickling in. So I received a couple items, and I do have a card to share with you guys. I received a card, and yeah, that's pretty much it. So we're going to go ahead and get started. So the first thing I'm going to share with you is the card that I received from Gabby, and this is from Mommy and her four little ladies, and she had hosted a challenge back, I think it was during the winter time, Christmas time, and she just sent a little card saying thank you, and I thought it was the cutest thing. It says, better late than never, thank you for participating in my giveaway challenge, and it says, I appreciate your friendship and hope we continue to be crafty friends. So, thank you so much, Gabby. I thought this was really, really cute. And she did include a couple little die cut pieces in here, which are little bows. Oh, I didn't know that. I think, yes. So here is a snowflake, a little tree, super cute. And then she also included some bows that I can put together. So thank you so much, girly. You know I love my bows. So thank you for that. And I do want to leave a link down below for Gabby's channel, but also a link to a challenge that she's actually hosting right now for her daughter Lexi. If you watched my last video, I did a VR, but if you missed it, the link to that video again will be here. It's basically making two birthday cards for her daughter who is 5 years old. That's not hard, guys, and she would love to get some birthday mail during this month. So go ahead and check that channel out if you aren't familiar with it. So thank you so much, Gabby. And I love the little sealant there. So cool. So thank you. All right, guys. So I picked up two items from Michael's. There were 33 cents each. We had walked in just a really quick little visit, and I saw some embellishments, planner accessories is what they are, but they're little pockets, and the prices actually said $1.99, but I went ahead and scanned it, and it was only 33 cents. So I thought these were cool. They're just little pockets and perfect to just add glue in the back and add to any type of flip book or even a tag flip, and then I can still embellish these. So obviously I won't use them for my planner, but I thought for 33 cents, that's a pretty cool little idea. So I went ahead and grabbed that. And then they also had these, which I wish I would have saw more, and they didn't. And these were only 33 cents as well. And they're cute little tassels, and they have like the gold hardware, and this one says love with the bling, and then this one has like a bow. Super cute. Definitely the colors that I work with. So for 33 cents, I was really excited about finding those. And that's all I found from Michael's. And then I finally went to a Family Dollar. It's like two towns away from where I normally live, and we were eating in the surrounding area. Me and my husband, we had came from a doctor's appointment. And I had told him, oh, I would like to stop in there because I've never been there before. And honestly, guys, I picked up one thing, which was these magnetic clips. And I thought these were really cute. It really didn't matter to me that they had magnets or not. I basically just got these so I can clip onto Happy Mail. Thought these were adorable. Now, to be honest, I was not impressed whatsoever with that store. I think some of the things were actually overpriced. There was things I saw that sold at the 99 and for Dollar Tree that were at least double or triple the pricing. So didn't care for it. We'll never probably go back. So yeah, but I did pick up those and I thought those were cute. So what I do have from AliExpress are, I ordered these like little foam little stars. And it's funny, if you guys pay attention to my videos, when I haul hearts, I call them stars. And when I call stars, I call them hearts. But today I made sure they are called stars. For the ones who actually pay attention and hear every word I say. But anyways, I ordered silver ones. And these were pretty cheap. And they're really cute. And they're slightly puffy. And I can use these for quite a bit of projects. I ordered gold. But instead, they sent me red. So I did, you know, take a picture of what they sent me, and then they did credit me back. So now I do have red to play with, but I guess that will probably be good for maybe patriotic themes, 4th of July, or even Christmas. I mean, or Valentine's. Stars are something that, you know, you can pretty much use for any type of project. So I did pick up those. And then I ordered a little Easter die. And I tried it out. And this was not good. I've ordered dies before from Allie and had no problems. But this one was not good. If you can see, like, the cutting part of it just isn't clean. So I can't rip out any of those letters. I ran it a few times and just didn't work out. So I did file a refund for this as well. Took a picture of it and they'll probably refund me the money as well. It was like $1.18, I think, including the shipping. So very, very cheap. But like I mentioned, I don't usually have problems, but this one is just defective. So I took a picture, made a little complaint about it. And so most likely they'll give me a refund. I don't have to do refunds very often with items, but when I do, it usually runs smoothly. So I'm not afraid to order from AliExpress. I know some of you guys might be, but I'm not. And plus I always buy things that are fairly cheap too. I don't spend a whole lot of money. So the next thing I ordered, and I already have it in this cute little jar. Whoops. I'm gonna show you guys. It's like a cute little candy jar. My nephew had a baby shower and him and his wife and my daughter guessed the correct number of candies. And I was like, girl, I'm keeping that jar. So she didn't care. But anyways, I ordered these little colored cotton balls. And they were like $1.91 for this package. So I ordered blue. That's also coming on its way. But I wanted to use these so I can make little mini cotton candy embellishments. And I've made them before with pom-poms that I have gotten as well. But the cotton is a little bit softer and it looks more real. And I'll show you guys what I did. So this is the little embellishment that I made. I think it turned out super cute. So it's using one of the little cotton balls there. I did use one. And then these are the little food picks from the Dollar Tree. And what I did is just cut it to size so it wouldn't be so long. And then left the heart part as the bottom. And then I just tied a little bit of baker's twine here. And then added that little cute felt heart. And I just glued it right there. And it was pretty much, that was it, guys. It wasn't that hard. I just stuck some glue onto the pick and kind of wrapped up the little cotton ball and it turned out like that. So I mean, if you guys want to see how I made it, let me know, but it's fairly easy. And again, you saw how much came. It was like $1.91 for all this cotton. Very cheap. And super excited how that turned out. So the ones that I've made before, and I have shared these on my channel, are these. And these are the ones that I made with pom-poms. Now these pom-poms I believe came from AliExpress as well, and they have a little bit of a different texture, almost like a foam texture to it, so they're very easy to mold. So what I did was I kind of just rolled it in my hand to make it more of a cone shape, and then it turned out like that. So you can see they're not as fluffy looking like a cotton candy would actually be, but overall you would probably get the guess of what that would be, which is a cotton candy embellishment. And then I used the little cake pop sticks, and actually let me see, I made these quite a few months ago, so they actually still kept their shape, which is nice. But it's like a very fairly light pink with polka dots. And then I just added some gold thread and then a little mini bow that came from Allie as well. But they're just very, I don't know, foamy texture, I guess. So they're still cute, but I wanted to try them with this instead. And I think when I get the other color, the blue and pink, I might split the cotton and kind of do like a mixture of colors. I think that would be kind of cool. So yeah, I just wanted to go ahead and share that with you guys. See, this is what I do. I make embellishments and then I put them to the side because you never know when you need to send out happy mail or join a challenge and you got things already set up and ready to go. So that's what I love to do, especially when you work and have kids and family things, and it's just crazy. So, but yeah, I thought this turned out super cute. So I wanted to go ahead and share that. And it's not my original idea. I've seen so many tutorials and so many pictures on Instagram, but I mean, things like this is fairly easy. Anybody can do it. And they're cute to add to embellish anything. They're perfect to embellish a bag topper or, you know, anything like that. So anyways, I've kept you guys long enough and I just wanted to come on here and let you guys know what I picked up and what came in. And I will see you guys on my next video. And don't forget to check out Gabby's channel if you want to join her little challenge that she has. I think it ends at the end of this month as well. So, all right, guys, I'll talk to you later. Bye.